Hey, what is up? Today we're going to go over a vital equipment glitch, which apparently was patched on patch 22 when it was released, which fixed an issue in which a player could complete a vital equipment multiple times per day if they already had one of the quest items. Well, it is absolutely not patched, and we're going to get into that. In order to do this, the first step is to acquire one of Ward's junk items. This lies around the world, you're not able to acquire it normally, so I will have a video down below where you can watch this and find one of the locations and get this. Once you've got one of the items, go ahead and put that in your stash box and then show up at Foundation. You should get the equipment quest to pop up. Once that's there, go ahead and talk to Ward. You should have the item in your stash box and not on you. This is the most important step of the glitch, because if you have the item on you when you go and talk to Ward, he's going to make you complete the quest anyways, and that's not what you want. You want that in your stash box and not on you. Once you have gotten the item at the location that Ward has sent you out to get, go ahead and go to your stash and put that into your inventory. Once that's in your inventory, go ahead and talk to Ward this time. So you'll have the item that Ward sent you out to get, and then you'll have the glitch item that you found on the ground. Once you got that, go ahead and talk to Ward, and then we're going to choose the third dialogue because that will give you more reputation. Now, once you have chose the third dialogue or the third option, you will then want to back out and go ahead and join a different server, or you can join the same one if it's a private server or if you're just joining back with your friend. It does not matter which one, and you're good to go. If you do not put the portable pack or the item back into your stash, you will lose it and you will not be able to repeat this a second time the next time you do this tomorrow. So go ahead and you'll notice when you go back, you'll have the vital equipment glitch popped up, and you're good to go to do it once more. And there you go. I hope that this was helpful. They did not patch this at all, which I don't know. Bethesda's got their whole situation weird going on with Microsoft. Apparently bought them out, as most of you may know. If you do not know that, well, now you know, and we could probably have a discussion about that. And I suppose to be more clear about it, I think it's ZeniMax or whatever. I just haven't really been too in-depth with it. Let's just hope that whatever change does come, does happen, and it does fix the game entirely, or just fix the overall Fallout series, because it really went down in a tunnel. And I'm not saying Fallout 76 is a terrible game, not at all, guys, but I definitely think that there was or could have been a lot more improvements before it was launched, and a lot of other things with the special editions and the jackets and how they were all weird, and the bottle of liquor that they were selling back then, and all that's just all of it was, I think there could have been more production wise, could have been better. But I think Fallout's a great series, and I'm definitely glad that this might, or hopefully might, be positive change. But this is it. I hope all of you found the glitch helpful, and I'm gonna head on out. Take care.